In this video, we'll be showing you how to program the programmable keypad found in several AES products, such as the DECT wireless intercoms, hardwired slim and stylus comms, and the standalone keypad systems. I'm going to show you how to do this with this display DECT 705 wireless video intercom we have here, but the process is identical for a range of different AES intercoms which use the same programmable keypad. The programmable keypad is easily identified as it has three LED lights above the keypad. The unit must be powered for a minute before programming can begin. Firstly, we need to enter programming mode. To do this, we need to enter 0000 followed by **. The middle amber LED will remain solid to signify that the keypad is in programming mode. Now that we are in programming mode, to add or delete a code from the keypad, we need to enter a string of numbers in here. The first two numbers signify the relay for this code to trigger. 10 equals relay 1, 20 equals relay 2, and 30 is relay 3. The next option is 2 to add a code or 5 to delete an existing code from the keypad. We have no saved keypad codes in this unit yet, so let's add a couple. So we hit 2 to add a keypad code. The next three digits confirms where this code should be stored. 000 to 999 is for relay 1 keypad codes. It is important to note that all keypad codes need to have their own location on the keypad's memory. So for example, if you save two codes in the same memory location, then this will just accept the latest code, overwriting the previous code in that memory slot. We will use location 001. Next, you enter your 4-digit keypad code. I will use an example of 1111. Then you hit the hash key to confirm and that code is now stored. So to go over that once again and add a second code, we will then put 10 for relay 1. 2 lets me add a new code. 002 is the memory location for the code. 1112, then hash. Now if we exit programming mode, you will see that 1112 and 1111 will be accepted codes for relay 1. If we want to enter a passcode for relay 2, then we enter programming mode 0000 **, 20 for relay 2, 2 to add code, 001 for memory location. As this is relay 2, then it is a different location. Add your code, 4321, and the hash to confirm. Now you have three keypad codes in the keypad. Two codes for relay 1 and one code for relay 2. You will notice that when you enter the code for relay 2 that the red LED will activate. The red LED indicates an action on relay 2. Changing the programmer code is important for both security and programming of the keypad. The programmer code allows you to secure your intercom. It is important that you make note of this code when changing it, otherwise a full system reset is needed, which deletes all programmed information and codes on the keypad. The keypad itself can be programmed with 4, 6 or 8 digit long keypad codes. However, your programmer code needs to be the same length. That means if you want 6 or 8 digit codes, your programmer code must be also 6 digits or 8 digits long. To change the programming code, you need to enter programming mode, 0000**. Location number, which is always 01, then enter your code in either 4, 6 or 8 digit format, and hit the hash key. This is now your new programmer code which will be needed to enter or delete any further keypad codes on the keypad itself. You can add a super code to the system, which is one code that operates all relays on the system, a great option for caretakers or site managers. To create a supercode, firstly enter programming mode and then 02 and enter your chosen supercode, and then hash key to confirm. So we are in programming mode here, then we hit 025555 as our supercode and then hash to confirm it. To use the supercode, enter the code followed by hash key and then the number of which relay to trigger. So if our supercode is 5555, we key 5555 hash 1 for relay 1, 5555 hash 2 for relay 2, and 5555 hash 3 for relay 3. For units with prox cards or tags, the process for programming these is also simple. Enter programming mode by using 0000**, hit 10, 20 or 30 for relays 1, 2 or 3. Once you have chosen which relay for this tag or card, press 1 to add, then select a free memory location such as 005, then swipe the card or tag on the sensor and hit hash to validate it. To delete a card from the system, you need to follow the same procedure with one difference. The third digit in the sequence changes from a 1 to a 5, leaving it as 105005#. This deletes the data from its unique memory location and leaving the card no longer functional until it is programmed into another memory slot. So that's it for the basic programming of the programmable keypad found in several AES intercoms. If you have any questions, just post them below.